position his people. So here it is. Your relationship will bring you out of the dry place into a prosperous place. Yes, your relationship will bring you out of a dry place into a prosperous place. So the scripture said in Samuel chapter 7, verse 7, he said, fetch him out of the house of Machir. Fetch him out of the house of Machir, the son of Ambiel from Lodibar. Bring him up from Lodibar. That's a good word. Even in the midst of this pandemic, even in the midst of people being laid off, even in the midst of people not having enough, they're running short, they have lack, God is going to restore you. God is going to turn things around for you. I don't know how he's going to do it. That's why he's God. We are the creatures. We are his children. There's a scripture in First Chronicles 2:9. 1 Corinthians 2:9, pardon me. Say, eye have not seen, ear have not heard, neither have entered to the heart of man the things that God has prepared for them that love him. But because of us, of our love, of our relationship, of our connection with him, God is going to turn it around for you. Was speaking with Bishop Ronald Kimball there at the Life Center Church in Eatonville, Florida. He was talking about Malachi 3:10. The Lord say, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. That's a great word, because God is going to turn this thing around for you. God is going to do it for you. Whether relationship or reputation or deficit, God is going to cause you to move again into the abundant place. So David desired to be a blessing. God desires to be a blessing. He asked, is there any in the house of Jonathan that I could bless? I say, that's a good word. Thank God I'm one of the ones left. Mephibosheth is in a messed up place. But the king wants to see him. The king said, go get him. He was in the house of Lodibar, means a dry place. God is calling you from your dry place to your blessed place. That's a great word. God is calling you from your dry place to that blessed place, a prosper place. Everything you touch is going to prosper because you're blessed. I like what Bishop Joseph Warren Walker to say at Mount Zion Church there in Nashville. He said, man, don't be looking for a prophet to prophesy over your life. Prophesy over your own life. Speak blessings on your own life. Dig into the scriptures. Look at the word. Believe the word. Believe the word that God is telling you. Speak blessings over your own life. Watch God bring you to the level of increase. And whatever is planted, watch this, by that which flows, grows. Say it again. Whatever is planted, by that which flows, grows. Psalms 1, verse 3 said, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth his fruit in its season. Whatsoever he does shall prosper. When you are planted by God, you will grow. When God has planted you in a place, you will grow. So, stay in the flow of God. No matter how low your money gets, stay in the flow of God. Keep trusting God. Keep believing God. Remember what Malachi said? God said, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. Testing comes. Tough times don't last. Tough people do. I want to say stick with it. This is, I was looking at one of my sermons from time back when I preached at Nazarene Full Gospel Church there in Mobile. And they have a new pastor, God bless you. It talked about the season of an unexpected blessing. God is going to give you an unexpected blessing. So just stay faithful. Stay faithful where God has planted you. And watch God turn things around in your favor. This is your season to be blessed. He said you shall be planted like a tree by the rivers of waters that bringeth forth your fruit, your produce, what you've been working on, the vision you've been working for, the vision that you wrote, that you've taken your time to write the vision, to make it plain, that they who read it may run. God is going to allow that vision, the one that people said you were finished, people wrote you off, said you were through. That vision, God is going to turn that thing around, and that you will have fruit in your season. Whatsoever you do shall prosper. When you are planted by God, God is positioning you. David came looking for a crippled boy. That's kingdom connection. God is looking for people who've been crippled by this pandemic. God is looking for people who laid off. God is looking for people who lost marriages, people who lost cars, people who lost homes. God is looking for you. He's going to turn it around for you. Mephibosheth was crippled, wow, in both feet, and could not walk. But the king wanted to see him. King Jesus wants to see you. Jesus has a blessing with your name on it. He's waiting on you to get in position. So when you get in position, you will find out that you have similarities like the king. You think like the king. You decree like the king. The Bible said, if you declare, and Job, if you declare and decree a thing, it shall be established unto you. So you got to remember that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and of a sound mind. Yeah, wash your hands. Practice social distancing. Practice 6 feet standing apart. But you got to remember, God is with you. God has given you a sound mind and a power of love so you can make it in this tough season. And your responsibility is nothing but just let your light shine. You don't have to make it shine. My dad, who pastored over 40 years, my dad said, you don't have to make it shine. But Matthew 5:16 said, let your light so shine that men might see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. And if you let it shine, I promise you, he will turn it in your favor. God bless you. God keep you. Recalibrate, readjust, realign, and watch God bring the tremendous increase into your life. Listen, do me a favor. Go and subscribe to my YouTube page, Dr. Kenneth M. Young Preaching, Dr. Kenneth Young Speaks To. And you will find some things in there that will bless you. Most of my messages, written over 2,000 messages, published 5 books. It's messages of hope. And it's amazing that in this season, I was talking with Pastor Friend this morning from Orlando. My messages are geared, had the mindset of hope. And what more did we need this time in this season than hope? God bless you. God keep you, is our prayer. God bless your people. Smile upon them. Lift up your counsel upon them, giving them peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Until next time, be blessed.